everybody. My name is Nina from Bad Cat Family. I am here with my cat Noah, who wants to help me film this video. I am a zookeeper. I run an online cat boutique called badcatshop.com. And here on YouTube, I talk all things cat care. Today, we're going to be talking about walking your cat on a leash and harness, and more specifically, the dreaded flop. So if you're watching this video, hopefully you haven't even gotten to that stage, because this is going to be a lot easier to prevent than correct. You know it when you see it. It's when a cat seems so uncomfortable in their harness, they just kind of flop over and lay there like they can't move, even though they definitely can, and they act a little pathetic. So that's totally normal, but I want to share several ways to help get your cat more comfortable wearing their harness so you can get to having more safe adventures with your cat. Step one is going to be training your cat properly to get into the harness and wear it. So if you already have a cat that's already in the harness and doing the flop, maybe we have to take it a few steps back and get back to the initial training. If your cat already has a negative association with it, then this might take a little bit longer. The absolute number one tool that you're going to need besides the harness is patience. And I can't stress that enough. If you clicked off the video now, I hope all that you get out of it is that you need patience and time with your cat. This is not a mandatory thing. Cats do not need to wear harnesses and leashes and go outside for walks. Many of them are content being inside only. So this should be fun for you and your cat. So it might take some patience to make sure that the whole process is comfortable. So when training your cat to wear the harness, like I said, patience is super important, and you're gonna wanna break down the process of putting it on them into many, many, many steps. The first step would be to have them get comfortable with the harness off of them. So this harness might smell new, they are unfamiliar with it, they might not trust you with it, so give them some time with the harness in their environment. Let them smell it, get their scent on it. It's just a random object and has no negative meaning to it to them at that point. And then you can start building a positive association on top of that. Then you're gonna start the steps of putting this harness onto your cat. But again, take it in baby steps. And you know you've pushed it too far if on that step they start feeling uncomfortable. So for any one of these steps, don't progress forward until your cat is totally chill with the step you're on. Then you can bump it to the next level. So I would say the first step would be handling that harness, just you, not with your cat, just in front of them. And you can be manipulating the clips, undoing the Velcro, if that's what it has. These can be very, very scary sounds, kind of alarming. The clicks of some of the clasps can be loud. So give them time with all those sensory items first. I mean, you already take care of the smell. It's been in their environment. Maybe it's been on their cat bed. It kind of smells like them. So now let them get used to these sounds as well. Pair these sounds with positive things. Maybe do it every time at dinner. So every night that you give them dinner, that's when you bust the harness out and you start making these sounds. Then they're gonna have that positive association. Oh, this is great. Every time this harness comes out, it's dinner time. Once they are not fazed by the sounds, sights, and smells of this harness, it's time to start with the touch and actually touching your cat. Again, these lengths between these steps are just whenever your cat starts to feel comfortable with the previous step. It may take one day for that. It may take 1 week for that. Up to your cat. Again, starting at feeding time, get the harness out, feed them their dinner, and start touching the harness to them briefly and immediately taking it away. That can be it for the day. And extend it with longer periods of time, as long as the cat is still feeling comfortable and continues to eat. If they run away when you do this, you may need to take it back a notch until they're completely comfortable with that previous step before you move forward. Each time you can progress forward a little bit. Maybe you can start putting it on the cat's head, maybe over its ears, maybe start touching around their neck a little bit. Don't push it too far too fast, because then it's gonna be harder to make up from a negative experience than to just build up slowly with a positive one. If you want more in-depth examples of how to put a harness onto your cat, I have a video that I will link above, and it's two different methods depending on your cat's preferences of how to train them to put the harness on. But again, patience is going to be key for all of the different methods. Now we're on to step two, is now the harness is on your cat, and very typically they will flop over even if you've gotten them comfortable with the steps of putting, I always have cat hair, y'all, always. It is very normal for a cat to just flop over even though they've gotten comfortable with the steps of putting the harness on. Now they feel it on them, and while they might not be too upset, they don't feel as confident as they usually do in how they move because they feel something on them. So they'll just flop over and lay there. So here are now the tips to help stop the flop. Tip number one is very similar to the training method of getting the harness on your cat in the first place. Once they have their harness on, let them eat their favorite foods in it. Let them eat their dinner. They're going to be way more focused and honed in on the food, again, some more positive association. They're gonna kind of forget that harness is on them, and they can spend more time getting more used to it and more comfortable. Make sure that if they are eating while they have it on, make sure the process of you taking it off, they get a reward for that too, because that process can be kind of scary as well. So have maybe treats right after dinner, high value something right after for letting you take it off. The second tip to help your cat stop the flop when wearing their harness is to build their confidence while they're wearing it. So what's the best confidence booster for cats? Is hunting or stretching? Okay, your cat is gonna be their most confident when they are hunting and trying to catch prey. So what can you do for that? When they're in their harness in your house, start playing with their favorite toys and have them chase it around. If they are toy motivated, toy driven enough, they're gonna forget about the harness. They're gonna wanna chase that toy around. My last tip for making them feel comfortable in their harness is doing other training sessions with them. If they already have their harness on and they know other behaviors like sit, paw, lay down, target, anything like that, they're gonna have those positive associations. Training time should be fun, they get rewards, so they're more honed in on working with you during a training session than they are with this harness on. So all of these different things, eating their food, playing, chasing toys, and doing other behaviors in training, they are all non-compatible behaviors with flopping over. Essentially, you can't be flopped over and chase a toy. You can't be flopped over and be sitting up and eat your dinner. You can't be flopped over while giving a paw high five. So having them do non-compatible things with flopping over will reinforce that they can be doing their normal everyday behaviors that they would normally be doing just in a harness. Step three would be taking them outside for the first time in their harness. You have slowly trained them over time to let you put the harness on them and be comfortable with that. You have stopped the flop inside and made them feel comfortable moving around in their harness inside the safety and comfort of their home. And then third, it's time now to go outside and build their confidence while they're in the harness out there. First, we're gonna start again with patience. So I know that you may wanna go on a huge walk your first time and show them everything, but you should start incrementally. Start with them at the front door while harnessed up, and let them just explore the threshold. Go at their pace and let them feel confident in where they're going, what their new territory is. This is very spooky and new. So if you push it too far, then you're making it a negative experience and they're not gonna wanna do it again. And next time they see that harness, they're gonna think, negative experience, you threw me out into the big spooky world. Let them just go at their own pace and you're gonna have so much fun and success. And it's fun to watch where they wanna go. Another tip for making them feel confident in their harness outside is to take them outside during a time of day or in an environment where there's going to be less stressors. So whether it's time of day to avoid excessive heat, a time of day to avoid excessive car traffic, or people maybe right after work walking a ton of dogs, or choose areas where there aren't going to be a lot of stressors or distractions. The third tip to make them feel the most comfortable and confident while outside in their harness is giving them an escape plan. I wanna be super clear that harnesses are not going to be escape proof. None of them are. Your cats are very wiggly and agile for a reason. They're great little hunters and survivors. And while this harness is going to give you a great security blanket to make sure you kind of quickly get your cat. They can slink out of it if they're completely provoked and terrified. We don't want that to be in their minds as their escape plan. I like to provide my cat with an escape plan of a cat carrier. So we like to use a cat backpack, and that way it's really only associated with these fun adventures and it's a safe space. I don't use the same carrier that's like the hard-sided carrier that I take to the vet, because it's got a lot of negative associations and my cat is not gonna be running to that for safety if there's a dog out and they wanna dart under something and slip out of the harness to hide. Instead, my cats know, run to that backpack, I'm gonna be scooped up off the ground and we can go home, or at least protected in this backpack. So give your cat an escape plan, and it's going to make you and your cat feel a lot more confident that they don't need to wiggle out of their harness just to be safe. That is all for today. If you have any questions, please drop them below. If this video is helpful at all, please give it a like. We love making cat videos for you all, and the more likes, the more cat treats we can buy and the more videos we can make for you guys. If you have any tips of your own, I think the comment section below is an awesome place to share. It's kind of like a community. Everyone that's watching these videos, I'm assuming, is also a huge cat nerd like me and like you watching, so you might have some really great insights to share. So please drop those below. If you want more cat content and you love watching cat videos and building your relationship and bond with your cat, please consider subscribing. We'd love to have you along in the Bad Cat family. Till next time.